If you're actually listening to and gaining your information from children, that's right.
So who cares? Why not do your own thing and let them say what they want?
What's up, guys? Today, we're gonna do a Halloween look, I guess. I have been in this makeup for like 16 hours or something. I went hiking with Jay and his sister and her husband. So yeah, we were just playing Mario Party, which was fun. And now I have to get into like making a video gear. And I've been running up and down the stairs because I keep forgetting to bring my fucking SD card. So we are just gonna do a fun playing with makeup look real quick. Is this even attached? It appears to be attached. I think we are good. This is the quickest I've ever gotten into video mode, so things are gonna be a little fucking weird for a while. And I think I'm gonna like freshening up my makeup, but then I'm probably just gonna immediately take it off right away. I have to get into my, I have like a thing full of like SFX makeup. It's like a box. Yeah, is it this box? No, this is the box with the, it's got like extra lip glosses in it, but we might actually need the blood red one, so we'll go with that. I'm just gonna do something simple. I do wanna find my SFX blood, but I'm not gonna do any scars or anything. This year, oh, here it is. This year has been very crazy. I know you can't see me right now. I apologize. This year has been really, it's been a crazy fucking, oh, I have like nothing. Where's my blood? Where's my blood? Where's my blood? Where are you, blood? Should we just recreate? I know I have, but where's my blood? This makes no sense. Maybe we can use ears as well. I don't know. Should I do like a satanic elf? I got these when I was getting stuff for my birthday shoot at Party City. I saw these and I thought they were really cute. They just like go clipped in your hair and it makes you look like a demon or whatever. And I have no topic today. I'm just off the cuff. We're gonna hang out. We're gonna chill and hopefully we're gonna play with makeup. I thought I had some fucking shit, but I don't know. Do I? I know I would never throw away my fucking... Where? I don't have any blood. Where's my blood? If I were my blood, where would I be? If I were a person using blood and I needed to store my blood somewhere, where would I put my blood? We'll try to find it at the end. Let's actually make this an interesting video. How about? So we took Jay's sister and her husband to Calico Tanks, which is one of my favorite short hikes. And then we went out to Shake Shack and then we came home and played 3 games of 10 turn Mario Party, which was really fun because even though Mike, Jay's sister's husband, is kind of a gamer, he doesn't play as much anymore. And his sister is like a person who grew up gaming but then stopped gaming in her adulthood. Oh, dude, like the best part of every horror look is the blood and I don't have any? I'm confused. Okay, I'm gonna get down on my knees and we're gonna find us some blood. By the way, I'm still wearing the same leggings that I went hiking in. Just now I'm wearing like a tube top that's black and red because that's like Halloween scary. Oh, I know where it is. I know now where it is. Okay, it's under here. I put everything under here that I actually use, I think. We'll see, we'll see. Oh yeah, we got makeup cream, we got spray blood. Where's regular blood? Yes! Ah, we found it, my guy. Oh my god, I'm so happy now. I was gonna cry myself literally to sleep and then shoot myself in the face, only in joking form. I was gonna enter some kind of video game where you can actually see yourself in mirrors because there are too few video games where the mirrors actually work. It's so annoying when you see like a fucking AAA game and it's like top tier graphics, but then anytime you see a reflection of yourself, you're not actually there. That's so fucking annoying to me. Just like not having any footsteps in sand or snow. That is literally the bane of my existence in video games. So I had a, let's not have my titties pop out. I had a topic that I wanted to talk about and now I don't remember it. I have no fucking clue. So yeah, we're just gonna darken up this makeup. I should probably get my beauty blender. Well, yeah, I should probably get a little wetter. Oh my god. Will this ever end? This is me being not prepared. Okay, all right. I kind of just want to clean up this area real quick because it's so dirty. And I'm looking at the viewfinder up here as kind of my mirror because it's in the way of the mirror. I don't know if I should leave my eyes bloodshot. You can't really tell that they're that bloodshot right now, so I think I'm just gonna leave them that way. It also kind of plays up the whole experience, you know? Wow, that's my last wet wipe, so I'm not gonna use that. I don't really feel like I need to fix the face makeup because at least on video, it looks pretty good and I'm gonna take it off right away anyway. So let's just go ahead straight into... We've got the Too Faced Peach Palette. I'm gonna be using just the darkest color, the tempting color, because I just want like dark eyes. What do I want to talk about? Okay, my card got full, so I had to spend like 20 minutes with my arm back there going like, oh, fucking leave. I don't know. This is a really small card. I refuse to take the card out of my point and shoot because the last last two hikes, or a hike and then not a hike and then a hike, those two hikes with one hike in between that I did remember the memory card, I forgot the memory card, including today. Is any of this making sense? Where is my fucking eyeshadow vagina? I don't know. Everything's out of place. I've never made a video in quick succession like this. Where is the fucking thing I wanted to use? The utensil I wanted to use here. I am so confused and distraught. Okay, let's just start with the under eye because I can't find the other one. Hopefully we can do this in a timely manner. Oh, I didn't take a before. There we go. That's my before. There's a little bit of stuff on there, but whatever. Oh my god, I got it on my cheek. Ah! Ah, I got it on my cheek. Guys, my life is just so hard. I don't understand. Every single day I wake up and I do this wonderful thing as my job. And for some reason, somehow, I still manage to fuck everything that I do up. Just kidding. I don't actually feel that way. I'm just like being dramatic right now. I don't really know what to talk about. Should we talk about the climate change girl? I don't want to talk about the climate change girl, you guys. Okay, let's talk about using children in politics because that's the first fucking topic I can pull out of my ass. And I really don't want this to be a Tara just talks about her day and complains about random happenings. I got my ASMR mic back, by the way. So that means that I'm gonna start making more ASMR videos. Oh, you haven't seen the first one yet. This is all out of order. When I'm being confusing about my timeline, it's because this is a video I'm actually filming 2 days before it comes out because I want something cool like this for Halloween. But most of the videos that you see in the next month are gonna be videos that I recorded literally 2 weeks ago or something because I've been trying to get ahead and I am now in the vicinity of putting videos into December. So I've gotten all of my birthday month, all of November, done with so that I can take November off, but I'm also starting to get a little bit more ahead so I can continue to be ahead once I come back in late November, early December. So yeah, my first ASMR video comes out on November 1st. Any of you guys who are at the $3 plus level on my Patreon have already seen this video, and I actually really enjoyed creating it. I'm not someone who gets the tingles or really enjoys listening to or watching ASMR. So it's not really for me, so I didn't think that I would enjoy creating the content, but in all honesty, I had a lot of fun creating it. It was really calming, and I actually did like listening back to all of the noises that I was making in my headphones because the way that they create that content, and I guess the way I now create that content as well, is listening back to what the sound sounds like so you know the appropriate distance to keep it from the mic and stuff. It's like actually kind of an intricate, cool thing, and I had a lot of fun with that. It was very relaxing, and it's also easy content. I'm not gonna lie about that. That's not the main reason though. I actually do enjoy creating it. If it was like mind-numbing, especially because it's like a long format, so you don't really cut it that much, which makes it easier. There's not a lot of post to be had there, but it's also like I don't have to do as much setup. What my setup is gonna be finding things that will make cool noises for you guys, like in the wild and in my house, and testing them out. And then also I'm gonna start doing like cosplays and having themes for them. Kind of like I have themes for my base covers whenever I do a base cover. I want to have themes for these ASMR videos and do kind of things that people haven't really charted into with the ASMR genre, at least that I've seen. I, you know, admittedly don't watch it really, so it's hard for me to gauge if someone's never done what I'm thinking about doing before, but it's not like the common stuff. That being said, I do want you guys to give me input because this is a format that I'm willing to try anything. Like if there's some sort of sound that you want to hear, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just like fucking around. That's the best thing with makeup is when you don't really know what you're doing, but you just like do stuff, you know? I don't know, for some reason I love that. Just like start doing stuff, see if it looks good. See, I just decided to put a lighter color on my lid here and blend it with my fingertip, whatever, why not? How does that look? Looks whatever, cool, let's continue with that. I can never do like a full smoky eye, it looks weird on me, I don't know, like with the black. I do brown smoky eyes like almost every day that I wear like a lot of makeup, but with every other color smoky eye, like the black ones, that always looks good on blondes, especially like Pamela Anderson era blondes or like Playboy era blondes. They always look really good and sultry, but I just cannot pull it off or something. I don't know. Anyway, let's redo my contour. Let's actually darken up the contour on my nose, and can we get a spoolie to try to get this shit off my fucking face? So, kids being utilized in politics. As much as I find the Parkland kids to be extremely cringy and I disagree with them, and I don't think that you having a traumatic experience and living through it gives you any kind of expertise that other people don't have other than and wow, that's a lot more emotionally impactful than I thought it would be, and I lived through that. That's crazy. That's basically all the expertise it gives you. But I do feel like they have a legit reason to be up in arms. Like, they genuinely feel that way. They genuinely, well, most of them, save, like, I forget what his name is. There's, like, one Parkland kid from the Parkland shooting that is conservative, or two. One or two. And the rest are just, like, really like, oh my god, this needs to end. Gun control. Oh my god. And at least they feel that way, and they aren't being pressured to feel that way from some adult, you know? And that's often what happens with children, like the Greta chick, the climate change chick, and I'll put the link to her speech down in the description. But I can't imagine that without her parents' intervention, she is so distraught about something that is not currently affecting her as a child. I just can't even imagine. I don't care that she has certain mental disabilities, like I think she has autism or something. I don't know if that's considered a mental disability. I'm not the PC person, so don't come at me with that shit. I won't care. But it doesn't really matter to me about that, because that doesn't make you actually stupider or unable to grasp topics. What does suck is when parents are instilling in their children this, like, crisis mentality in order to push an agenda. And it's not 100% fact that it's her parents doing, but her parents haven't allowed her to be a kid. There are plenty of scientists that say that climate change is a real thing and that we are speeding it up or even making it happen altogether. I don't care about that. That's not what I'm talking about here. I'm not arguing climate change, even though, okay, we're not gonna get into it. I'm not arguing climate change. I'm not arguing for it or against it. But what I am saying is there are plenty of people more qualified to talk on this than a little girl. So why would you put your child, unless you have some kind of agenda, why would you put your child through the stress of feeling like an apocalypse is coming, even more so than is indicated by a lot of scientists, just to push an agenda? Why would you allow her to be taken out of school? Unless it's something that you see as a parent, which is so unlikely, that at that age she is genuinely all of a sudden up in arms about by her own research, and she just happens to be this climate change savant. I don't think we should take away from her, like a lot of people say. I don't think we should take away from her her ideas, her thoughts, or her experiences, or what she feels. I don't think we should try to shut her up and be like, you're just a kid, there's no possible way. But I do think that we need to take everything that a child says with a grain of salt, because their brain's not yet done developing, and there are plenty of smarter, older people with more experience and more expertise in the field of the certain science that they are talking about that we should be listening to more if you really do want to appeal to authority. But I think whether it's a child or not, you should have the sense to be like, is this true or is this not true? Let's look at all of the data. Let's try to take myself out of my bias as much as possible and try to understand where both sides are coming from without demonizing any side or without trying to find the one little characteristic of either side that makes that side a little bit less credible. Like, let's not be like, oh my god, Greta has autism and Greta is a child. Let's not be like, oh, Greta is being manipulated by her parents, even though I agree with that. That's probably a proper assessment. Instead, let's just be like, well, Greta is wrong because, and let's talk about the actual idea. It's so weird to me that we are not allowed to criticize children who have put themselves in the public eye. That doesn't make any sense to me at all, because I think we should be able to criticize literally anyone as long as they are putting themselves out there. Or even if they're not, we should be able to criticize them. That's part of being in the real world. Yeah, you want to shelter children from that, but if children are willingly jumping into that world, I don't feel like this is dark enough, so I'm darkening it up. If children are willingly putting themselves in quote-unquote harm's way, obviously no one, child or adult, should ever, like, have death threats levied at them or something, or especially legitimate ones where someone comes and tries to harass your family or dox your family or whatever. I don't think that's ever okay, but just saying, oh my god, this is the past of Greta, or oh my god, this is why Greta is wrong, or criticizing children who put themselves out there, I don't have any problem with that. And that is, I agree with a lot of people, the reason why children are manipulated in politics and things, because people see children as these untouchable things that can do no wrong, and it's just so cute that they're, you know, I even have this feeling on my bias when I see a child saying some, like, anti-woke shit or some shit about, like, I don't know, guns or something. I always think it's cute, but I would never be like, wow, that's one smart kid. I would be like, that is a kid that either just said whatever came to their head and doesn't have the potential brain capacity to scrutinize what they're saying enough to actually make it smart. Like, if you're actually listening to and gaining your information from children, I cannot help you. And if you're one of those people that's like, oh, we can't criticize children, but we can use children as fodder in politics, I cannot help you either. So I really see this Greta thing as a non-issue, not because she's, like, obviously not an expert, and also not because it was the cringiest speech ever that was clearly, in my opinion, brought on by feelings instilled in her from her parents, who are, you know, pretty clearly, if you look at them and if you look at their background, they have that same political bent, you know? It's kind of like there's a difference between your child feeling like they're transgender or something, or your child feeling like they want to do something weird or different, like, for instance, doing esports as a job or something. There's a difference between that genuinely manifesting, and then there's, like, obviously the parents are into that, so the kid is into that, and we don't know to what extent, because we can never know, because we're not in the, you know, household, we can never know, but it really seems like that particular bent is coming from the parents and the way that they've raised their children. And, you know, I foresee a lot of people in the comment section saying, like, oh yeah, well, we're all products of our childhood, or we're all products of what our parents have taught us. But yeah, we kind of take all of those experiences as an amalgamation that we use in our adulthood to make decisions, but we shouldn't be listening to children who have not yet reached adulthood, that is their honest interpretation of the world, and that honest interpretation would even be relevant. I can't imagine being like, wow, this children is onto something that I've never thought of before. No, it's like, this child is fucking promoting my political bias, so, oh my god. Oh my god, beautiful and brave, you know? I just don't think that people should be trying to act like things that aren't issues with her are issues. Like her unrelated mental issues or anything like that, you know? I don't know. We should just take children in politics and children in media the same way, almost, that we take celebrities in politics. Like, just take that shit with a grain of salt. Know that whoever's pulling their fucking leg is formulating that agenda in their minds. I literally cannot talk while I do this. I guess it doesn't have to be perfect. It could be, like, kind of fucked up. I don't know, this is gonna look really dumb. I just want to get to the blood part and the hair part and the ears part. That's all I want. This is gonna be crap. We're gonna talk about random stuff. I hope you guys enjoy this. Maybe you won't. I don't know. I'm sorry if this is a shit video. It is kind of all over the place. So is this what I wanted? No, this is actually a different one. I need an actual red, like, for my lips. This is gonna stain my lips and I won't be able to get it off, but I need an actual red because this cannot be done without an actual red. I don't know what else to talk about. I've actually honestly been kind of avoiding all of the political and social commentary videos. For one, because I've been so fucking busy getting ahead. And for two, I don't watch that much YouTube right now. It's crazy. Usually I watch a lot of YouTube just while I'm getting ready and setting up, or like I'll take some downtime. But now the only downtime I take is like when I eat, and then I'll watch I Shouldn't Be Alive episodes, which are great. Such good production quality. It's an old Discovery Channel show that's now been syndicated on YouTube. I've seen the show before in the past, but now it resonates with me more because I'm more of an outdoors woman. So I like to see how people can fuck up and like nearly die doing things that I also do, like hiking and mountain climbing on a daily basis. I think that's really interesting. And like, I kind of get entertained while also getting information on survival skills and basically what not to do. It's more of like a cautionary tale of what not to do. Sorry guys, hold on, I gotta put on my fucking eyelashes. There are so many things I wanna talk to you about, but I don't wanna spoil like the things that I'm gonna be doing for my birthday, so I'm not talking about them. And those are basically all that's on my mind. At this point, I've almost like kind of checked out from content creation. All I have to do now is film as many more videos as I can. It doesn't really matter anymore. Like, I've gotten to the point where I definitely already have enough, and then edit a few, and that's basically it. And all I'm waiting for, guys, I have this Halloween special coming out on the 28th and the 29th, which is coming up fast, and I am so fucking excited about this thing. I put so much work into it, even though this has been like a rough month, just getting things ready and stuff. Not like rough in like a way where you need to worry about me, but just rough as in like, it's been very busy. This is the busiest part of my year, and for some reason people keep coming into town. I had Cody come into town, I didn't see him. I had Chris Starling, which is a friend of mine. You guys might not know that he's a friend of mine, or you might not know who he is, but I had him come into town, I didn't end up seeing him, and then Jay's family now coming into town, we did see them, but we're only seeing them for today. And I don't know, it's just been a lot on top of doing videos, but I'm very happy because I've only gotten stressed once, and that was like yesterday while editing a video, because I really didn't want to be editing that video and then then the video is also something that I feel like could possibly, I could have issues with YouTube. I don't think I will, but it's possible that I could. So that's always annoying. I don't feel like I have full creative freedom with YouTube. So sometimes when I have a cool idea, I think about how like, oh, well they could like strike it or something, even though it doesn't deserve to be stricken. And that like puts me in a bad mood about it. And it's like pretty dumb, but yeah. I kind of want to do eyeliner because I don't know. I'm just doing literally whatever. We shall see what happens. Wahahaha. So how have you guys been? I will be reading the comments as always, and I would love to hear how you guys have been. Oh, I feel like I want to use this as contour. This like black. Yeah, just like what's on my brush already. To like kind of contour my face a little bit with it. Oh, this is gonna be so hard to clean up. But yeah, so I was stressed out because I was editing a really technically hard to edit video yesterday, and the whole time it was like really annoying to edit, like more annoying than I thought it would be to edit. And the idea, when I thought of it, I was like so excited to do it. And then when I was editing it and I was thinking about like how much the YouTube TOS is kind of tightened around creators' necks and stuff, and I was thinking like, wow, this could actually be something that originally I would be able to make, but now would be something that would be harmful to my channel. And it like really put me in a bad mood, on top of the fact that it was one of the more technically difficult things to edit other than the Halloween series. But yeah, please watch the Halloween series, give it a shot. There's a part one and a part two on the 28th and the 29th. It took a lot of editing, a lot of effort. It was like a 5-day production, 2 days for the hikes. I don't want to spoil too much, but it is a Halloween special and it's really cool. And I would appreciate if you gave it a little bit of love. Just give it a shot. If it's not for you, you can stop. You don't have to watch part two. But please, if you don't watch many of my videos anymore, or it's like only occasional, I'd like to see if this can do well on YouTube. Because generally my views have been like dropping, and I've heard this from other creators as well, but it's like the visibility is really bad. Okay, that gives it more of like depth, I guess. I don't know. I'm just gonna like jump in the pool after this. It's been a long ass day. I'm gonna send this footage off to Red for pre-editing, and then I'm gonna jump in my damn pool and enjoy my damn self. All right, let's bring this in a little bit more. Gotta snatch up my nose a little bit. This looks real dumb, but that's okay, we having fun. I guess I'm gonna use my last wet wipe. So yeah, while things have been busy, it's been nice. I like that I'm working toward a goal and it's not super stressful to complete the goal because I have been pretty close for a while, you know? Like I've been working on getting ahead for like since beginning of September, and now it's almost end of October and I've just been like grinding, grinding, grinding. I haven't been streaming as much, which does suck, but I think it's okay because I'm trying to reach a goal, and I do wanna like stream a little bit before my birthday and during my birthday. I think that would be cool. Okay. Oh, before I do this, I should probably do the blood I want to do so I don't get too much in my hair. I guess I have a hair appointment before anything else that matters. So, blood. That's the spray blood. I do like me some spray blood, you know? Ooh-hoo. That's right. And then, let's do some hair. I hope you guys have a great Halloween, though. I am going to try to stream on Halloween and maybe do another makeup look or something, but I wanted to do something for YouTube. Initially, I had something else planned for this upload day, but I was like, why not do this? This seems fun. Where's my brush? So that was just the spray blood. I put the other blood on later. Let's put my ear on. We're gonna do a blood elf. Quite literally a blood elf, but not like a wow blood elf, like a Terra blood elf. Like a bloody elf. That's what we doing. These are like so oddly hard to put on. There we go. I always think I did it and then I didn't do it. Okay, hair behind the ear. Oh, I wanna fluff this up a little bit. I think if I turn down the ISO, it'll look a little darker and more menacing too, because I'm just trying to get this shit looking sexy. So yeah, I miss you guys on Twitch. I hate it when I don't stream for a while, but I have to be able to take these kinds of breaks from Twitch, because otherwise I feel so overwhelmed and stifled if I have to stream a certain amount. That's why I don't ever want to make Twitch my job. You have heard me lament about that before, but I could never have that kind of schedule where I have to do something for like 8 hours a day on a schedule, because my schedule shifts forward naturally. Like I like to have 16-hour days. Oh god, if we could just darken this up. All right, so I'm gonna take the actual blood now and All
I don't want to get it on the floor.
I think that's good enough. Now, for the finishing touch. Sorry this wasn't relevant. What do you guys think about people using their children in politics? Do you think children should be allowed to talk on really serious issues even if they aren't? Because children are minors. Everyone should be able to do whatever they feel like is right, you know? This is not good. But like, as far as children go, if it was your child, would you let your child talk on this stuff? And would it change if you disagreed with your child? Like, if it came from an organic place, but you felt like what your child was saying was incorrect. Like, I don't know anything about people parenting, because I'll never be a parent and I don't want to be. But I hope I'm not dripping on the floor, because that would suck. I already got some in my hair. My hairdresser's gonna kill me. Okay, so what if we lower the ISO? I guess I would have to stop the thing. Let's just add more so we don't have to lower it to make it look good. I hate blending eyeshadow. I'm so heavy-handed with it. Oh, my eyelashes sticking together. Okay, I think I'm overdoing it at this point. Let's try to buff that out a little bit. Make it look more quote-unquote natural. And then we will turn off the backlights, zoom in the camera, and do a little montage, a little after montage, yes. Wahahaha. Oh my god, there's a ghost in the background! Which is what Mikey from Glamgore would say when it's focusing on something that's not me. Okay, do you think that's cool? I think it's kind of cool. I like these. I feel like I need to do like a side part. Can I get away with just reparting my hair right now? Can I do that? Because I don't like this side part that I have. It needs to be a middle part is what I meant. If I said it needs to be a side part, I meant it needs to be a middle part. I think elves like typically have middle parts. But that means I need to like put more of the black on this side. Part down the middle. I don't know. To me, that looks more elfy. Ugh, these do not stay on well. Now I'm elfier. I think that looks cool. Now to put these back on and then we are done and it's more symmetrical. Okay, I'm gonna take some pics. I'm gonna take some vid. Let's go ahead and do the ending montage. I'm sorry this was a shit video. It was fun though. Did you like it? Let me know if you liked it. Because if you don't like this kind of thing, I'll only do it. Or if you didn't like this particular one, I will only do it when I actually have a really good few topics that I can talk succinctly on, and that's like the main purpose of it. But today, the main purpose was just to fuck around and have a video for you guys that's more Halloween-y because even though I have the Halloween special coming up, it's not this. This is what I usually do, like some kind of weird, crazy, like makeup, you know? So, without further ado, let's jump into the montage. My mouth is numb. God, I love playing with blood. It actually got cooler when I started fucking it up, to be honest. Just rubbing my face, to me, actually made the look more attractive, if I'm being honest. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Like the video and subscribe to the channel. Seriously, if you did. If you like this, let me know. Because to me, this felt like a clusterfuck that I was unprepared for. But it was nice and quick, so maybe if you guys like the quicker stuff where I just quickly talk about something that was on my mind and play around with makeup. I need to go wash out my mouth really bad, but I'm gonna use these for something else more impactful at some point. But if you liked this video, please do let me know. I love you guys so much. I hope you have a great... I go. I hope you have a great upcoming Halloween. Oh, there. my teeth clean again. And I hope you have a wonderful week, because yeah, I just love you guys so much. The more and more I get into content creation, the years that pass, the more I appreciate you guys, not the less. And I never ever try to take my life or any of you guys for granted. Like every day I wake up thinking like, wow, I'm so lucky to be doing this. And it is so much fun to just create whatever the fuck I wanted to create in the day and just have a good time. I'm gonna zoom this all the way out so you can see all of me. But yeah, gonna take a thumbnail, gonna sign off, and gonna clean this shit off of my face. Thank you from the bottom of my heart, and have a happy fucking Halloween. Bye, guys. I just simply could not go a Halloween without playing with fake blood. It is my absolute favorite thing in the world, and now we're going to take all of our makeup off because I feel like that would be a more interesting thing than the whole of putting the makeup on in the first place. Wow, I look like a fucking crazy person. Gonna take off my 666, guys. Wow, I look crazy, what the fuck? I have like fake blood and really old makeup all over my face, making me pink.